Eric Becker, naturopath. Thanks for coming back to my channel. High blood pressure. Who's got high blood pressure? How many people have got it? A few of them have. Statistics show that about 19% of people in the United States have got a blood pressure that is, in fact, not even properly controllable by medications. So blood pressure is a real issue with many people. But the mechanism behind blood pressure, particularly if we've got what we call essential hypertension, or if we've got a blood pressure with no known cause, you know, what's the point in treating something really and effectively wanting to treat it if you don't understand the cause of that condition? So we've been doing an awful amount of research, not me, but I mean the scientific community in general, regarding the microbiome. We know now that the bacteria in the gut have a link with many different conditions, neurodegenerative, degenerative conditions. We even now believe that Parkinson's disease and some dementias are linked up with a poor gut. We've seen poor gut function now linked with depression, anxiety, various psychiatric conditions. We've seen it linked up with autoimmune disease. We see it linked up with so many conditions. But what about high blood pressure? Is there a link? Well, research conducted recently, they looked at a group of about 50 people with high blood pressure. I think these were people with pre-hypertension, so going into hypertension. They also had a group of 99 people who actually had high blood pressure, and then a smaller group of around 30 people. I think that was 41 people, sorry. 41 people who were basically normal. They did not have high blood pressure. And what they found when they studied the microbiome or the bacterial gut, you know, contents of these varying three groups of people, is they found that the people with the normal blood pressure tend to have the highest diversity of gut bacteria, whereas the people with the hypertension and pre-hypertension had smaller microbiome, so their species population was down. So again, there's no definitive link here. We can't say that if you've got, you know, more a larger microbiome, more species, that you will have lower blood pressure. But the crazy thing is, if you look at countries, you know, particularly countries like South American countries and many indigenous peoples who have larger populations or species in their gut of these bacteria, they don't tend to have high blood pressure. They don't tend to have diabetes. They don't tend to have a lot of diseases that we have in the Western world. So again, this could well be, in the future, it may well be revealed even what types of bacteria are linked with hypertension, and how, you know, we can encourage the microbiome to become more balanced and large in population size by manipulating our diet and lifestyle. And this is still, you know, fairy tale talk at the moment, but I don't think it will be in 50 or 100 years from now. They'll have the microbiome nailed. They'll have it mapped out. They'll work out what bacteria we need to have in what quantities, and also hopefully the best possible food and lifestyle that will achieve that aim. So this is going to push us well over 100 years of age, the average human, if we can pull it off. And I think we will pull it off. But meanwhile, if you've got high blood pressure, you can't stop taking medication. But have a good think about improving your diet, especially the biodiversity, you know, different types of vegetables and fruits and grains and nuts and seeds and legumes you can put in there that are going to help to really boost that gut, which should boost your health in general. Hey, don't forget to click on the link in the description box. There's a pretty cool shopping report that you might like to have. Thanks for tuning in.